guys, on today's video, I'm going to teach you how to set this guy up. So this is everything you need to know how to get started. So let's start off with the lights. That's something that we must know before we even get started. So this light up here, once it's a solid green, then that means it's your best connection. This connection is between this guy, your extender, and the router. That means if you have green light, that's the best connection you can have between this and your router. So if it's too far away from your router, it's gonna go in a solid amber. That would mean it's a good connection, but not the best. Or a solid red, which would mean that it's a poor connection. And if it's off, there's no light at all, there's no connection. So this is officially way too far from your router. So it does need to be halfway in between wherever you want your connection to go. So if your router's right beside it, let's say here, and the room that you want it to be is over here, don't put it in that room. Put it right in between the two, your router and that room that's not getting that Wi-Fi signal. Now this light right here that's gonna turn on later on is your device light. This light needs to be a solid green for best connection. What does that mean? Well, that means that this, between this and your computer, for example, that means you guys have a good connection. So your computer and this guy right here, good connection with a green light. With an amber light, good connection. With red, that just means a poor connection. No light at all means no connection. As for your power light right here, this will light up. So again, we're looking at a solid amber for your power. That means the extender is booting. So it's an okay light. If it's a solid green light, that means the extender is powered on. And if it's off, it's just off. Same goes with WPS. That just means with a green solid light, that means your Wi-Fi security is on. If it's blinking green, then that means your connection is being established. And if it's off, then that just means your security is off for WPS. So there's two ways to set this up. And I'm gonna teach you the easiest way, and I think the best way that you guys can set this up, which is through a web browser. So what we want to do in order to get started is plug this in really close to your router. So that's just for the setup. Later on, we're gonna plug it and plug it wherever you guys like. But for the setup, plug it in very close to your router. So right now we're just gonna plug this in right here. Then you should see this light coming on. That's perfect. So at this point, just wait until your router is fully booted. So that means it's turned on a solid green light. And then we should see Netgear right here. So just go into Wi-Fi and connect to the Wi-Fi that that's putting out for you. Once you're connected, we're gonna go into a website that we have to go into in order to set this up. Or if you're using an iPad or iPhone, you should see this popping up, which is perfect. So we're just gonna go into new extender. Now I will put down the website down here below if you didn't get this, to go into that website and set up your account from there. Just make your account and then you're gonna get this page where it says Wi-Fi range extender. That's what we're doing right now. We're not doing an access point. We're just setting up normal as an extender. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. So at this point, you should see this popping up. It should take a little bit to refresh and you're gonna see these two options. So it's up to you if you want to share both of these or just extend one of these. So I could just extend my 5G or just extend this one or just both of them. In this case, I'm gonna do both of them. So I'm gonna click on tech and design because that's my Wi-Fi. And I'm gonna go on next. Then it's gonna ask me for the password for my two Wi-Fi channels. Once I put in both my passwords, I'm gonna go ahead and select next. And it's gonna set up the connection between the extender and my router. At this point, you guys can select the name of your network. I'm gonna leave it as is. Select next. Once it's done set up, it's gonna kick you out of there. And you're just gonna see your Wi-Fi networks. That's where we were at before. I'm connected still there, but I should see these two connections, which I just made right now. You guys saw the two that I made, plus other my networks that I will see right here, which is fine. But the important part is these two that I can connect up or just be hooked up to my original router connection. At this point in time, we are done, so we can unplug it. And just in case you guys were having problems, the on and off is right here. So if it never turned on, just turn it on by pressing this or off, okay? And at this point, we're just gonna plug it in somewhere else and we're pretty much done. Just make sure it's halfway there And remember the lights that I explained to you guys? That's very important. So as this turns on, it's okay if you guys see the power as an amber light. Later on, it should turn green. Same thing goes with WPS, that should turn green. And right here, a router, you don't want it to be a solid amber light just because that means it's good, but it's not the best. You want it to be the best, so you want that to be green. A solid green would be your best connection. And from here on the device, with that, we have to see once you connect your computer or your iPhone, iPad, whatever you guys have to this network, we're gonna see if the connection is good or not. Really, you don't really need that light. You'll notice it on your computer itself. So that light is almost a waste, but the other lights are very important. So for some reason, the upload speed is almost the same between the two, the extender or my router. However, the download speed does differ. Okay, so it is a significant difference right there with our download speed between 57 and this 149 with the extender. So the extender is doing a good job right now. I don't think I'm gonna move it around more, but it is good to play around with it in the house to see where's the perfect spot. Anyways, that would be it for this video tutorial. If you guys have any comments, questions, you guys can write down here in comments area. Don't forget to subscribe and rate. Thank you.